Do you ever wonder how materials in the products and the power you use every day get to where you live, or how they get from your community where they're found and made to other communities across the country and around the world? From New York's Ogdensburg to Minnesota's Duluth Superior, harbors across the Great Lakes connect to each other, connect with nationwide shipping routes, and connect to the rest of the world, supplying the products they need, but not without dredging. Like federal highways, federal navigation channels and harbors need to be maintained. One of the key ways is dredging by the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers. Dredging is the removal of sediment like gravel, sand, silt, or clay from the bottom of a waterway to create or maintain the right depth for navigation and other purposes. Dredged sediment looks like wet soil and is a resource that can have many uses. Dredging is done with specialized vessels that scoop, scrape, or pump lake and river bottom sediment into barges, hoppers, or onshore facilities, and it's done all across the Great Lakes. Great Lakes harbors are part of a complex navigation system spanning 1,600 miles. There are 140 federally authorized harbors, including 60 for commercial use. Approximately 180 million tons of commodities are transported through these harbors each year, providing more than $2.1 billion in national economic benefits. And if you live in any one of the United States' 8 Great Lakes states, there's a good chance your life is impacted by this system. Federal harbors on the Great Lakes are typically located at the mouth of a river along the coastline, and these waterways are important for transportation related to commerce, recreation, and national defense. But where the rivers meet the lakes, natural currents erode shorelines and deposit sediment in the Federal Navigation Channel. Over time, they build up into mounds known as shoals that can block the movement of boats and ships. And while your average recreational boat doesn't need to sit too deep in the harbor, larger ships carrying raw materials and products or Coast Guard vessels patrolling the coastline do need to. Dredging ensures they can move safely and efficiently. Here's an example. The harbor in Toledo, Ohio holds incredible value to the United States. On average, nearly 10 million tons of commodities like coal, iron ore, and soybeans travel to and from this Great Lakes harbor. A ship full of iron ore traveling to Toledo needs to sit pretty deep in the water. If the federal channel isn't dredged to its authorized depth between 28 feet in the bay and 25 feet up the Maumee River, that ship might be forced to light load, meaning carry less than its full capacity of cargo. And fewer goods on a ship means more trips, which is less efficient and more expensive. And that runs counter to the role the Great Lakes navigation system plays in supporting fuel efficiency. A Great Lakes carrier is significantly more efficient than any form of ground transportation, 59% more than rail and 773% more than trucks. 1,000-foot laker carrying approximately 70,000 tons can move the equivalent of 7 100-car trains or 3,000 large trucks. And besides being fuel efficient, maritime transportation facilitated by Great Lakes harbors brings jobs and revenue to their communities. Waterborne transportation facilitated by Toledo's harbor supports nearly 2,800 jobs, more than $649 million in business revenue, and another $200 million in labor income to the transportation sector. But to keep Toledo open for business, it takes a lot of dredging each year. A total of 25 miles of federal channels are dredged from Toledo Bay into the Maumee River. And with an average of 800,000 cubic yards of material dredged every year, this Ohio harbor accounts for 1/4 of all material scooped or sucked out of the Great Lakes. To put it in perspective, that's enough sediment to fill dump trucks bumper to bumper for 450 miles, the distance from Toledo to Cleveland 4 times over. That's enough dredged material to cover an entire American football field and stack it 400 feet high. But we can't put it all on a football field, and it's not economical to truck it elsewhere. So all that dredged material needs a place to go. After it's dredged, the contents of the sediment are tested to see which of several options are most suitable for where it can be placed. The three main options include open lake placement, confined disposal, and beneficial use of dredged sediment. Open lake placement means moving sediment dredged from harbor and river federal channels further out into large bodies of water like the Great Lakes. Once it's moved from a dredge site to a designated open water location, the sediment is released or pumped into littoral zones or deep water where it can settle to the lake bottom. A confined disposal facility, also called a CDF, is a structure made to hold dredged sediment. It can be built from stone, steel, concrete, or earth. Some CDFs are owned and operated by the Corps of Engineers, while others are maintained by local partners. Historically, CDFs have been used to contain dredged material that was not suitable for open water placement or beneficial use. And when a CDF is getting full, it can potentially be expanded to hold additional material. Or, when a CDF is full, it can potentially be capped and used for other purposes, like parks, bird and wildlife habitat, or campgrounds. Dredged material can be a valuable resource for the ecosystem and the economy, as well as federal, state, and local projects. Beneficial use of dredged material is defined by the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers as all productive and positive uses of dredged sediment. That covers a broad range of categories from fish and wildlife habitat development to human recreation and industrial and commercial uses. It can include land-based projects like sediment recycling for use on farm fields, capping landfills, or other industrial site remediation. Beneficial use can be aquatic projects like beach nourishment or construction of artificial reefs, shoals, or islands, or wetland restoration. The Army Corps of Engineers' goal is to use 70% of dredged material for beneficial use by the year 2030, and collaboration with our federal, state, and local partners is the key to success. With all these options, who decides what will happen to dredged material at commercial harbors, and how do they get to that decision? The Corps of Engineers, in consultation with stakeholders and the public, creates a dredged material management plan for each commercial harbor. Called a DMMP for short, the plan identifies dredged sediment placement options and evaluates which ones are technically feasible, environmentally acceptable, and the most cost-effective. The Corps of Engineers works through the DMMP process with partners at the state, local, and community level for input. Steps of the process include specifying problems and opportunities, inventorying and forecasting conditions, formulating options known as alternative plans, evaluating the effects of those plans, and comparing them. The final step of the process is to select a recommended alternative for where dredged material will be placed or used over the short and long term. The U.S. Army Corps of Engineers Buffalo District is evaluating alternatives for dredged material management at each of its harbors, and that's where you come in. We're interested in any input on additional opportunities for beneficial use from stakeholders and the public. All comments received will be considered as we continue to evaluate alternatives. For more information on dredged material management plans at a harbor in your community and to provide your input, contact us by email or visit our website using the link in the video description.